Hansen TV. I'm still in Monaco. I've had a horrible week. That's basically it. Internet poker-wise, it's been horrible. Some would say catastrophic, but I'll just stick with horrible. I've been losing a lot, and apart from that, I haven't been getting enough sleep, been playing too much poker, not enough exercise, not enough sex. Plenty of things I've done way, way wrong this week, but now I'm back here in the recording studio. Hope to make up for my mistakes, and we'll see how it's going to work out against Mr. Oh My God. So far, I started with 51,000 and 50,000, and I think I'm just going to stick with that. No rebuys, no nothing. Kind of a little bit of a silly race up front with a king, king, queen, five. Of course, when a five comes, it looks a little sweeter. It does look a little sweeter. I'm going to skip the 5-6-6-5, 5-6-6 king, double suited. And I'm just going to lead out for the 12,000 here. And see if the 3-5s are good enough. I have no idea what Oh My God has. He could have straight draws. He could have me beat for all I care. Obviously, I'm not going to fold for the last 30,800. I did say obviously. Did I mean it? I probably did. So, maybe he just has a 5 and I have the best kicker. That's possible too. No, he has a 9 with it. That was kind of a tough hand to get away from, all things considered. What did he have? He had the 9-8-5-3. So I said kind of a silly raise up front. Not that silly when you consider that he limped in with 9-8-5-3 of hearts. I don't know why he limps in with that hand instead of just folding, but there's a lot of things I don't understand. As it turned out, we got all the money in and I only had 5 out, so. Am I gonna stick to my word and just stick to the one buy-in? I think I probably should. But since this is gonna be a short recording session, I'll buy in for another 50. See if I can do a little bit better with the next 50. I should be re-raising him more. Obviously, he's raising just about every hand on the button, so not sure I should let him get away with this. He's kind of controlling the action from the button, and that's not really the way you want to play. Here we go, another raise. Ace, 6. The 6 is not even for the nuts. Backdoor hearts. That's not backdoor hearts, that's not backdoor anything. So, not a good start. I'm in for a total of 150. And could get out of $13,000. I think I'm outplaying myself. I'm outsmarting myself or doing something. Anything. That's a beautiful hand, all things considered. Okay, I'll just limp back. 3,000. I don't see any chance how I can didn't see any way I could have the best hand. Now he's raising from up front, and I have the very in-between flop of the king high flush draw with three hearts in my hand and nothing else. I can graduate to a straight draw if I hit some of the right cards. That's not quite the right card. I think I'm just gonna let it go. Suddenly I made my flush. Did I want to make my flush? I think I wanted to, but this would be such a weird check behind again. But I just have a bad, bad feeling. As I said, he's racing to 2,000 with just about any hand, so I'm a little bit steamed, as you might be able to see, since I re-raised with an ace-7-5-5, one suit. It's probably just what we call a poor decision on my part. Basically just a poor decision on my part, and now I'm basically, for some weird reason, I just committed myself to this hand. 12,000 more, I could call the 12, in which case I could still fold. I'm not going to fold if I hit an ace or a 5 or diamonds. Or a couple of sevens. I obviously hope he doesn't have the two kings. I don't think he has the two kings. No, he's drawing slim. There's the hearts. No, there wasn't enough hearts. Not enough hearts to bag it up. And suddenly it's not that horrible. I'm only stuck 10,000. I got entangled into an ugly hand in an ugly spot with the ace-7-5-5. I've been asked by quite a few of my compadres. They're asking me, well, why are you showing all the hands that you play on Gus TV? They can go in. The Oh My God play in the tricks that you're in danger can go in.